Okay, so I shared this post from the Ugandan rapper JNL Zamba, where he said, now the Uganda has its first Oscar win from a descendant of the soil, parents should upgrade and recognize the opportunities in the arts field. Start training the children early. It creates opportunity for both the teachers and the students. You might groom the next director, actor, choreographer, sound man, or best-selling writer. My thoughts were, African parents need to be more supportive about their children's career in the arts field. But we had reactions like this from this guy who said, parents have also always done their best. It's the evil government which doesn't recognize the importance of art, just politicizing everything. Every coin is spent on keeping the dictator in power. People like you who hustled on their own to greatness with little help here and there deserve all the respect. But if the government prioritized arts more, we would have many more JNLs. Other industries like tourism too would develop. But the evil fellas running the country have their brains still in the 19th centuries. Okay, he's basically saying it's the government, not the parents. Parents do their best. Yes, I do believe most parents do their best. I also think mindsets need to be changed about potentials of careers in the arts. Some other reactions that caught my attention were these people who said, this young man was spotted and helped early on from a young age by British Academy for Perform Arts and nurtured his career to where Uganda can claim his success. Somebody else goes on to say, congratulations at Daniel Kaluwa. Talent is talent, though let's not claim talent that was nurtured out of Uganda. He worked for it with the help of foreign help, though we are proud he is from Uganda. Kongs Daniel Kaluwa. Then somebody else goes on to say, sorry, Uganda cannot take credit of an Oscar win based on the blood relation of a person it did not educate, did not raise, or give the privilege of honoring before he was successful. There's so many artists in the diaspora that are fighting the hard battle of getting into the music industry or Hollywood. We will only salute them when someone else has done the hard work of giving them a platform. What is our contribution? Spam, Nigeria and Ghana are inviting their own home and paying real homage to their artists in the diaspora. We, on the other hand, we are waiting in the shadows to lay praises after the hard work has already been done. And I do agree with this reaction, let me say 80%, because on the other hand, yes, Daniel Kaluwa was born in Britain, although his parents originated from Uganda, but he was born British, right? And he grew up, he was nurtured and trained, everything. Uganda, on the other hand, is the genetics, is the sperm, is that, right? Now, JNL was talking about parents being more open-minded about their children taking a part in the artistic direction. Now, this must not necessarily just be parents based in Uganda. It can also be Ugandan parents in the diaspora, African parents in the diaspora, just need to be more open-minded about their children taking parts in the artistic direction, right? Because like you listen to people, even Tiwa Savage, who for part of her life, for a huge portion of her life, she grew up out of the country. Her mom was not very for the fact that she should go into the music field, right? So even children who grew up in the diaspora still have problems. African parents don't still want them to go into this field because we don't hear the best things about people going to this field, or many people going to this field don't end up really successful. So these parents are doing it from a place of love, like I said in my first reaction to what JNL Zamba said. But on the other hand, if you're telling children that, okay, look at Daniel Kaluwa, a boy from Uganda, really, like okay, what are you trying to tell the children? These children who are back from Uganda, like the opportunities which Daniel Kaluwa has, definitely not the opportunities which they had. These realities, definitely not. That's why I do really appreciate like Burnaboy's Grammys, because it was somebody who spent a lot of his life in Nigeria. So he risked winning the Grammy. He also spent a lot of his life in Nigeria, grew up there, knows the reality. So children can relate to that and be like, okay, he grew up where I grew up. Okay, I can relate to him because we had the same kind of upbringings. We can relate one or two things, the same circumstances, come from the same level. And if he can attend this high, then I can definitely attend this high. But I'll say it's a little bit unfair if you say, okay, look at Daniel Kaluwa, telling the child from Uganda, look at Daniel Kaluwa, he's also somebody from Uganda, and look at the heights that he has been able to attend. Well, they didn't start on the same playing field. I don't think you can compare Daniel Kaluwa's story with let me say 90% of children in Uganda. Because when you look at it, he's the British Academy which he went to for training. Are there those kind of institutions back home in Uganda? The opportunities which he was given, are there access to those kind of opportunities back home in Uganda? So I think what we need to be looking at is, how can we make children who have dreams in the artistic field, how can we make the them get the highest level of success, maybe creating opportunities like that, creating training institutes like that. And one thing I'll say to the people, the artists in diaspora will make it, I think they need to come back home and maybe establish training institutes like that, like Daniel Kaluuya come back home and establishing institutes like that for, well, children like him who don't have the opportunity of going overseas to chase their dreams.
Thanks for watching that video. Hope it inspired you to want to commit to Chakara TV. You want more content from us? No worries, we got you covered. All you need to do is hit the subscribe button, hit the notification button, then sit back, relax, and enjoy daily content from us. It's been Eta on Chakara TV. We are craziness with a strategy.